In this video, we're going to explore how to work with AWS using IntelliJ IDEA. Let's start by setting up our IntelliJ IDEA to work with AWS. First, we need to download the AWS Toolkit plugin, which provides us with the AWS functionality in our IDE. In your IntelliJ IDEA Community or Ultimate Edition, open up your settings, select Plugins, and make sure the Marketplace tab is selected, then search for AWS Toolkit. Click the Install button, then after the plugin is finished installing, restart the IDE. After the IDE restarts, you will see a new AWS Explorer tool window. You can also access this window by going to View, Tool Windows, then selecting AWS Explorer. Now that I have my plugin, it's time to connect my IDE to my AWS account. IntelliJ IDEA uses credential files to connect to an AWS account similar to AWS CLI. If you already have AWS CLI or other AWS tools configured on your machine, IntelliJ IDEA may detect your config file and automatically connect to your account. If that's the case and you see a list of your AWS resources listed in this window, feel free to skip to the next section of this video. On the other hand, if your machine is like mine and you don't have any AWS credentials to choose from in this drop-down menu, click on Edit AWS Credential Files. Since I currently have no credential files, IntelliJ IDEA will ask me if I want to create it. I'll click Create. A new config file is created which contains comments at the top describing the contents of the file. Then I see the lines where I can enter my AWS access key ID and AWS secret access key. I want to pause here and mention that there are a few ways to set up access to AWS. I've linked the AWS Toolkit user guide, which includes the details on that process. If your company has an admin team that manages access to AWS, you may need to consult them on how to get command line access. The IDE uses the same credential files as the CLI, so if AWS access works from the command line, it will work in the IDE as well. I do want to show you how I configured my IDE to connect to AWS in case you're starting from scratch on your own personal AWS account. I'll switch to my browser and log in to my AWS Management Console. Then I'll navigate to the IAM service, and I'll choose Users on the left-hand menu. I'll click Add Users, give the user a name. For the access type, I'll select Access Key, which will allow me to use an Access Key ID and Secret Access Key to connect IntelliJ IDEA and any other command line tools to AWS. Then I'll click Next, and on the Permissions page, I'll click Attach Existing Policies directly and give my user administrator access. Then I'll click Next. I don't need any tags, so I'll click Next again. I'll review my summary and everything looks good, so I'll click Create User. Once I do that, I can see that the new IAM user was created and I now have a generated access key ID and secret access key to use to connect IntelliJ IDEA to AWS. I'll copy the access key ID and paste it into my config file in the IDE. Similarly, for the secret access key, I'll click on the Show button and copy it over as well. You want to be careful with your secret access key and not share it with anyone since it gives full administrator access to your account. I'll click on the Save button in my IDE and go to the AWS Explorer to check if I can see my new credentials. I can now see the default profile associated with my credentials, so I can select that, and once I do, IntelliJ IDEA will load a list of AWS services associated with my AWS account. If you run into any issues during this step, consult the AWS user guide linked in the description. Now that our AWS Toolkit is configured and ready to go, let's take a look at how to use it. You can view and modify your AWS connection information from two locations, the AWS Explorer window or the status bar. In the AWS Explorer window, the first drop-down menu will let you select between connections, which is useful when you have multiple AWS accounts and you want to switch between them. The second drop-down menu will let you choose the region you'd like to work with. Select all regions to see the full list of regions to choose from. Make sure you have the right region selected when browsing your resources in your IDE. There's been a few times when I couldn't see a certain resource I was expecting, and it turned out it was because I did not have the right region selected. In the AWS Explorer window, you'll see a list of different AWS services that you can interact with from IntelliJ IDEA. Let's take a look at a few. One of the most useful features of the toolkit is the ability to see your CloudWatch logs right within your IDE. You can do so by expanding CloudWatch Logs, which will give you a list of your log groups. I'd like to see the logs associated with my guestbook application running in production, so I'll double-click on Guestbook Prod, which will show me a list of log streams to choose from. If I select on the log stream I'm interested in, I can now see the logs for my application. My application is a Spring Boot app, and I see the Spring Boot logs showing the app starting. I can also filter events by entering in a string in the Filter Events window and clicking Enter. Another option for searching through the logs is to click one of the log messages and start typing a string to look for in the logs. You can navigate between the different hits using the arrow keys. Another service you can interact with in your IDE is ECR. You can easily create a new repository by right-clicking on the ECR node. For existing repositories, you can pull and push images to your repositories. One of the main features of the AWS Toolkit in IntelliJ IDEA is the ability to work with Lambda functions. You can create a new Lambda function by itself by right-clicking on the Lambda node. Or you can create a Lambda function that is part of an AWS serverless application by going to the New Project menu. Then you can select AWS as the project type. There's a great tutorial on how to build serverless applications that I've linked in the description. One of my favorite features of the AWS Toolkit is the ability to browse my S3 buckets right within my IDE. I can do that by expanding the S3 node, and now I can see all my S3 buckets. I can view the contents of any of my S3 buckets by double-clicking on it. From there, I can open the contents of my bucket. I can also create a new S3 bucket by right-clicking on the S3 node and clicking Create S3 Bucket. And these are just a few of the services I'm using for my application. Once you have your AWS Toolkit connected to your IDE, I recommend that you browse through the services you're using for your application and see what you can do with them. You can also use the Resources node to choose from hundreds of additional resource types and view them in your IDE. The last thing I'd like to point out is the Settings icon in the AWS Explorer window. If you click on that, you'll see some helpful links, including a link to the documentation which points you to the user guide I mentioned earlier. And also, you can see a link to the AWS Toolkit GitHub repo, which is open source. A cool option here is the ability to enable experimental features. For example, one feature that I've heard great feedback on is the ability to open an AWS terminal locally. I can enable this feature by selecting it from the menu, which will result in this new terminal icon showing up. And once I click that, IntelliJ IDEA will start a local terminal session with my current AWS credentials, which means I can run commands like AWS S3 LS to list all my S3 buckets. In this video, we explored some of the IntelliJ IDEA features that make it easier for you to work with AWS. Thanks for watching.